Hello, good morning all. Today in this video we are going to discuss regarding name create function in Odoo. So currently in the screen you are seeing Odoo version 15 community edition, where we are continuing our Odoo 15 development tutorials. So the point that we will be discussing is about the name create function in Odoo. So this is an ORM method, so we will be discussing about its use case and how it works and when we have to define or when we have to use this function in Odoo. So let's discuss about these points. So currently in the screen you can see we have got different appointments, and if I try to create a new appointment here, you can see I have added a new many to one field called operations. So if you go to the configuration, I have added a new menu and its related view. And you can see my new model is hospital.operation, and currently there is no record inside this model, and as well as I have just added a many to one field to that model from hospital.appointment. So if I go to the pie chart, here we have the custom add-ons and I am hospital. So if you check the models folder, you can see operation.py file where we have the model with doctor ID field. There is only a single field, doctor ID, and I have imported that in the manifest file, added a security for that model, and I have defined its view, operation view. Here I have a tree view, a form view is defined, action, menu, and it has been imported in the manifest file. So what we will be doing is that here we have a many to one field. So currently you can see it's empty. So if I go to the operations and if I create a record, I'll name it as Joel Wills, or I'll select the doctor Joel Wills there and I'll save it. And if I come back to the appointments and if I try to select operation, you can see the value is coming like this. So you know it's reason because we haven't specified a rec name for that model, or we haven't set any name get function for that model. That's why the value is coming like this. So you can ignore that. You already have learned how to set rec name and how to set name get function. So this is not what we are going to discuss. So once we create a record from here, it get appeared over here. So as it is a many to one field, if I enter some value which is not existing in that record, you will have the create option. So here you can see as there is no record with that matches with the entered string DDD, Odoo is suggesting me to create DDD. So if I click on create, you can see nothing is getting happened. So if I come back, if I type Q, you have suggestion to create QQQ. I have clicked on that, but if you come back, it's not getting created. And if you go to the configuration, then to the operation, still here you can see you have got only a single record here. And let me duplicate this tab. And if you come back to the appointments, open any of the appointments, and if you try to create a new operation with name Odoo Mates, create Odoo Mates, it's not getting happened, or it's not getting created. You can see it's not getting created in the corresponding model. But if you check where we can say, if you check this patient field, so here inside the appointment itself, we have the patient fields. So if I test like Odoo Odoo, and if I click on create, you can see it's getting created, Odoo Odoo. If I go to the patients, you can see Odoo Odoo is getting created, but the same is not happening with the operation field. So you may think why it is not getting created. So it is not getting created because we don't have a rec name for that model. So if you come to that corresponding model, models, operation.py, here you can see we haven't specified a rec name for this model. Also we don't have a name field in the model. So if there is a rec name for this model, that is if there is a rec name specified, the entered value here will be passed to that field and Odoo will be creating a record. If there is no rec name, the entered value will be passed to name field of that model and record will be created. But when there is no rec name and there is no field named, there is no field with technical name, Odoo will not know to which field this value has to be passed. So this is what currently happening here. Here we don't have rect name and we don't have a field with technical name. So Odoo doesn't know where to pass this value. So in this case we can utilize the rec. In this case we can utilize name create function in Odoo. So let's see how we can do that. So I'll do one more thing. I'll simply define one more field here, like operation name, and I'll put it as a character field, fields dot char. And I'll enter it as name. So simply I have added one more field, that is operation name with string name. So I'll go to the corresponding view and I will add it over here after doctor ID or before doctor ID operation name. I will add it here also, operation ID. So I'll just restart the service. So service has been restarted. Now I'll come to the UI and I'll upgrade OM hospital module. So I'll click on upgrade button. So you can see the module is getting upgraded. And if I come back to the configuration, then to the operation, you can see we have got the fields here. So if I put test operation, save, I have just changed that name. And if you come back to the appointments and try to create a new appointment, still it is coming same. And if I try to create EEE, and if I click on create, you can see still nothing is happening. So we will be defining name create function for this model. So if I come back here to the operation model, so we have to define name create function. So in order to do that, here we have the Odoo source code. And if I search inside the Odoo source code for diff name underscore create, you can see a lot of use case inside the Odoo source code. So simply I'll copy one among them. So here you can see we have a sample function inside HR department model. So simply I'll copy this function, control C, and I will put it here inside the hospital dot operation model. So at API model, diff name create self comma name. So in this name variable, we will be receiving the value that user is entering on the screen. So if I print this variable name, we'll be receiving what user enter over here and clicking create. This value we will be receiving inside this variable. So simply I have printed it. So if I enter, I'll put the name as entered value, I'll print it. Then what we will be doing, we will be passing this field to and saying I have to pass this value to the operation name field. So let's see what happens after we define this function. So I'll clear the log and I'll go to the UI. So let me close these pop-ups and I'll go to the UI and I'll try to create a new record called Odoo mates. So I'll enter Odoo mates, and if I click on create Odoo mates, and if you come to the log, you can see entered value is Odoo mates. And if you check here, if you refresh, you can see the record has been successfully created and Odoo mates has been passed to operation name. So here you can see we are passing the entered value to the operation name field and the record is getting successfully created. So this is the use case of name create function in Odoo. So it will be come into role when we don't have a rec name or a name field in our model. So once you have rec name, the value will be passed to rec name. Unless, suppose if I didn't specify name create function for that model, by default when you enter and click on create, the value will be passed to rec name of that model. Or if you didn't specify rec name, system will look whether we have a name field in that model and it will pass to that model. So once you don't have a rec name and name field, system doesn't know, and then you have to define name create function. And if you have rec name and name field and there is a use case where you have to pass to third field, you can use this function name create. So I hope you understood the working of name create function in Odoo. So if you have any doubts, feedbacks or suggestions, don't hesitate to contact us over the email, that is odoomates@gmail.com, and feel free to connect us in social medias like LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. So this will be working for many to one field as well as many to many, where we have such create options. So I hope you understood this topic. Thanks for watching, and if you like the video, please do click the like button and subscribe the channel and support us by having a comment, like, and share. So that's it for the day. Have a nice day. Thank you.